fantastic, Cody. Thank you so much, Tony. We have a bunch of questions for you, but be mindful of the time because you have a critical meeting after this. So I'm going to do this as a rapid fire round. Sure. So I'm going to throw stuff at you, which is all the different hats that you wear other than your trademark red hat. And you tell us what is the first thought that comes to your mind when you think about that. Long haul, low cost.
Erasure X.
All right, the only one. Daughter Stephanie.
My life.
We wonder what your wife has to say about it. Owner of Team Lotus.
Asshole.
Doing business in India.
Can't be repeated. No, you know, jokes aside, I'm going to say more than one word. Everyone jokes about doing business in India. I got to say, I've had a pretty good experience. And you know, it's not been easy. Doing business has actually been tough. Their competitors have been dog eat dog. I mean, you know, short of bringing a tank to Bangalore, you know, our competitors have really tried to stop us. But I find the bureaucracy okay. It's tough. I think it needs to change. But I think the airline industry has been poor in engaging the bureaucrats to understand what makes air travel work. The thoughts in most Indian government and bureaucrats is that air travel is for the rich. So they tax the living daylight out of the industry. While I'm saying, actually, if you look at AirAsia in Malaysia, now everyone can fly. That's our motto. It's not just for the rich. So, and the benefits to the state economy and the national economy are huge. So, you know, we've done really well in Karnataka. There are three or four other state governments that are talking to us. In fact, the chief minister, who was just before you, we're about to fly to Vizag. Bangalore Airport has been very successful. So it's how you engage. We're very transparent, we're very aggressive. The Indian media is fantastic because they kind of love stories, and I'm very good at giving them stories, both good and bad. So it's been great. I'm looking forward to it. And you know, we're going to give those guys in blue, Indigo, a real run for their money.
Real run for their money. Yeah. Okay. Promoter of Tune Hotels.
Me.
Yes, but what about that?
Again, we're talking, our whole business is about serving the underserved. So you can have a low fare, but then the hotel cost is so expensive. So we've tried to create a low value, high quality product, and we're not quite there yet. We're almost there. We've got 38 hotels, and I think we've got a great little product now, which appeals to the masses. And what we're trying to do is make a hotel stay functional, and easy, great bed, great shower, and take away some of the things you don't really need.
Okay. Queen's Park Rangers.
Oh, amazing football club. We've lost our first game. You can see there's an Indian audience because they have no idea what I'm talking about. Should talk about IPL. By the way, what happened to Indian cricket in England after such a promising start? No, QPR's been great. Look, it's my dream. It was unbelievable for me. I used to listen to football on shortwave radio. Most of you are too young to know shortwave radio, right? You have to hold a radio upside down, hold it by the cooker, hold it by the fridge. And there I was, watching the biggest game, probably in English history, Manchester City versus Queen's Park Rangers, which was probably one of the most amazing games. And I thought, wow, this is a real dream, right? And when we were going to the stadium, all the Man City fans were abusing us. I was with the players in the bus. And my partner said to me, you know, what you talk about dreams is really true. We were those guys on the outside of the bus. Now we're on the inside of the bus. And it's an amazing feeling. Football is amazing, and I'm sure in any sport. When you win, wow, unbelievable feeling. You know, when we won at Wembley in the playoff game, which was worth a hell of a lot of money, in the 89th minute, it was incredible. Probably one of the greatest days of my life. But when you lose, you want to kind of kill yourself. And but, you know, those are the highs and lows. But as I said earlier, if I get hit by a bus tomorrow, the feelings I've had in life, I'm one of those privileged people that have had such amazing feeling that I have no regrets. There are many people who think I'm mad owning a football team. But, you know, I came into this world with no money. And if I leave with no money, thanks to Piyush, and Queen's Park Rangers, it'll be all right. No bad feeling because I've had a great life.
And the last one. Receiving the Commander of the Order of the British Empire from Princess Anne at Buckingham Palace.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
Thank you, Tony.
Thank you very much.
It's been a pleasure. Thank you so much. Thank you. And a little token of appreciation.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
See you.
Thank you.